Hi dear students, how are you all of you? Dear student, you all are very warmly welcome on our YouTube channel. Dear student, already I have given two videos of this lesson number 5, chapter number 5, Religious Trend in Ancient India, part 1, part 2. The link is given in the description box, so you will get the explanation video quick. Now, we are going to understand exercise here. Yes, question one is that filling the blanks. See, question one is filling the blank, and the first filling the blank is the principle of dash dash is very important in Jainism. The principle of non-violence is very important in Jainism. Yes. Now, second is that an extraordinary feature of Gautam Buddha's personality is his compassion for all living beings. Yes. So, what is the answer? His compassion. An extraordinary feature of Gautam Buddha's personality is his compassion for all living beings. Now, next is see answer in short. Question 1, what were the teaching of Vardhaman Mahavir? See, what were the teaching of Vardhaman Mahavir? Vardhaman Mahavir told the people that the greatness of man does not depend on his varna but on his excellent conduct. Love all living things, have mercy and compassion, live and let live. There was Vardhaman Mahavir's teaching. Do you understand this? See, Vardhaman Mahavir told the people that the greatness of man does not depend on his varna but on his excellent conduct. Love all living things, have mercy and compassion, live and let live. These were Vardhaman Mahavir's teachings. Now next is that which famous quote of Gautam Buddha have you read here? What? Which famous quote of Gautam Buddha have you read here? What value does it upload? Yes, that we will read it here. Even the little quail can creep freely in her nest. This famous quote we have read in this lesson. This shows his thinking on the values of freedom and equality. Yes, what is the answer? Even the little quail can chirp freely in her nest. This famous quote we have read in this lesson. This shows his thinking on the values on freedom and equality. What virtues are emphasized in Judaism? What virtues are emphasized in Judaism? Judaism emphasizes justice, truth, peace, love, compassion, humanity, charity, ethical speech and self-respect. Yes, Judaism emphasized justice, truth, peace, love, compassion, humility, charity, ethical speech and self-respect. Now, fourth one is that what are the teachings of Christianity? The teachings of Christianity, we are going to understand it here. There is only one God. He is the loving father of all and is omnipotent. Second, it is believed that Jesus Christ is the Son of God who came to the earth for the salvation of mankind. Yes, what is the first? There is only one God. He is the loving father of all and it's omnipotent. Now, third one is that according to the teaching of Christianity, we are all brothers and sisters. We should love everyone, including our enemies. वी शुड फॉरगिव दोज हु एयर और गो रॉन्ग. यस. नाउ नेक्स्ट इज दैट व्हाट आर द टीचिंग ऑफ इस्लाम. सी टीचिंग ऑफ इस्लाम यू विल अंडरस्टैंड. द टीचिंग ऑफ इस्लाम इज दैट अल्लाह इज इटर्नल अब्सोल्यूट एब्सोल्यूट ऑल पावरफुल एंड मर्सीफुल. द पर्पज ऑफ ह्यूमन एग्जिस्टेंस इज टू वर्शिप अल्लाह. यस. नाउ सिक्स व्हाट इज एट द कोर ऑफ पारसी थिंकिंग. What is at the core of Parsi thinking? At the core of Parsi thinking are three main principles of conduct, namely good thoughts, good words and good deeds. Yes. Now next, writes note on Aryasattas. Aryasattas means what? There are four truth at the root of all human affairs. They are called noble truth or Arya Satyas. Yes. Dukkha means suffering. There is suffering in human life. The cause of dukkha. There is a cause of suffering. Dukkha Nivaran. It is possible to end suffering. Pratipad. Pratipad means the way. This way leads to the end of suffering. This is the way of good conduct. It is known as the Ashtangik or Eightfold Path. Now the Panchashil we are going to understand. Panchashil. Gautam Buddha asked people to follow the five rules. The rules are called Panchashil. Yes. Stay away from killing animals. Stay away from stealing. Stay away from unethical conduct. Stay away from telling lies. Stay away from intoxicants. Yes. See dear student, here we are understanding Panchashil. Gautam Buddha asked people to follow five rules. The rules are Panchashil. Stay away from killing animals. Stay away from stealing. Stay away from unethical conduct. Stay away from lying, telling lies. Stay away from intoxicants. Yes. Intoxicants. And the next question is that put the following in the proper place in the chart of the five great oaths and the three jewels. Yes. Ahimsa, Samyak Darshan, Satya, Asteya, Samyak Jan, Aparigraha, Samyak Charitra, Brahmacharya. These are the eight one. Yes. Now here I have made a chart for you. See. Five great O's are and three jewels. Yes. Ahimsa, Satya, Asteya, Aparigraha, Brahmacharya. Samyak Darshan, Samyak Jan, Samyak Charitra. Understood? Now here we can understand give reason. Why was the name Jina given to Vardhaman Mahavir? Why was the name Jina given to Vardhaman Mahavir? Vardhaman Mahavir was called Jina or conqueror because the joy derived from physical comforts and the discomfort felt due to undesired things had to impact whatsoever on him. The term Jain derives from the word Jina. Yes. Vardhaman Mahavir was called Jina or conqueror because the joy derived from physical comforts and the discomfort felt due to undesired things had no impact whatsoever on him. The term Jain derives from the word Jina. Yes. Now second is, why did Gautam Buddha came to be called the Buddha? Why did Gautam Buddha came to be called the Buddha? Gautam Buddha's birth name was Siddhartha. Yes. He had attained knowledge of human life in its eternity, entirety. Yes. That is why he came to be known as Buddha. Do you understand, dear student? All the questions I have given here for you, and you have to write this exercise in your notebook. Thank you.